Siddhartha by Hermann Hesse is one of the most meaningful, impactful books in my life. I've been reading it since I was a teenager. Anytime something major happens in my life, it's always good for a little bit of perspective. Today, I just picked up the book and I opened it. I was gonna look for a quote to share with you guys before I tell you why I'm ready to leave China. And it turns out I didn't have to look hard for a quote because the very first page I opened to, right in the middle of the book, I think it's quite relevant. Siddhartha wandered into the forest, already far from the town, and knew only one thing, that he could not go back, that the life he had lived for many years was past, tasted and drained to a degree of nausea. There are many reasons why I am leaving China today. Day-to-day life under COVID policies isn't really the biggest factor. Life has been mostly normal for most of the pandemic. I know that some people would disagree, but China's policies to contain the virus, especially in 2020, clearly saved lives of many millions of people in China. After the first few months of COVID in China, day-to-day life became slowly mostly back to normal. Sure, you had to wear a mask everywhere, and sure, you had to get a COVID test from time to time, but it really wasn't so bad. Everyone stayed healthy and safe, and we didn't have any major outbreaks of COVID or huge death tolls like the rest of the world. Even in 2021, as COVID restrictions started to increase and control measures were more and more strictly applied, life remained mostly normal. Call it Stockholm Syndrome, if you will, but I am very grateful for the policies that saved millions of lives, and I don't mind having to get a COVID test every 48 hours, like I've had to do for the past 5 months, if it means saving lives. If by me taking a PCR test every day or every 2 days saves just one person, then that's okay with me. We also don't know the real long-term effects of long COVID. I certainly don't want to get COVID and then be injured in some capacity for the remainder of my life. So even after leaving China, I will still take sensible precautions like washing hands, masking, and getting my booster shots. So no, the day-to-day COVID policies are not what is causing me to leave China. I'm leaving China today because China is becoming increasingly isolated. It is an expensive struggle just to leave the country, and an even more expensive, time-consuming, and frankly absurd effort to get back into the country. I fully realize that I am in a very privileged position in that I have the ability to leave China if I so choose. Many people are not so lucky. If you are content with your life being only in China, then to be honest, China still offers a pretty good quality of life. There are inconveniences and trade-offs to be made, but life still moves on and people can mostly do whatever they want. But personally, I don't want my life to be only in China. One of the greatest things about living in China during the past decade has been the fact that I could pop on over to Korea or Japan or Thailand. China was a great place to have a well-paid career and an exciting life, but also an ideal jumping-off point for travel and fun in other exciting countries and territories. Now, China is a country that is cut off from the world, isolated, and heading in one direction while the rest of the world heads in another. Just yesterday, there was news that Beijing told the public to prepare for 5 more years of mass testing and COVID controls. I don't know how accurate that is or if I should even believe it, but it would not shock me. Considering already the population is almost entirely vaccinated and COVID controls have only grown more intense since then. I am not the CDC, I am not a doctor, I don't have all the answers or probably any of the answers to be honest. But I do know that if I want to live outside of the USA, which I do, and I want to still be a member of the global community, which I also do, then China right now is not the answer, at least until China reopens to the world. It shouldn't cost anyone tens of thousands of dollars and take months of your life to leave and then to re-enter China. I want to spend time with my mom. She's no spring chicken. And I want to see my brother and my nieces. One of them's a teenager already. It's crazy. I want to go to my family cabin. I want to go to Japan and eat Kobe beef. I want to go to Munich and drink beer at Oktoberfest. I want to climb Machu Picchu. There are so many things in this world that I want to do that if my life is in China, I just can't. For now, if you want any of those things or anything else that the world offers us during our all too brief existence on this earth, then you cannot be based in China. It's sad. It's the end of a decade of learning, of growth, of good and bad times, but all good things must come to an end. And I'm leaving China because whenever something ends, at least in my experience, something even better comes along to replace it. So I'm leaving China right now for new beginnings, new experiences, and to rejoin the global community. I have nothing but love for China and Chinese people. I could say that I wouldn't trade my experience there in China for the world, but that's literally what I'm doing right now. I'm trading in China and going on to take on the world. So that's that, and can't wait to get out of here.